When you sit down at your table tomorrow, surrounded by those you love, what will make you thankful? Will you give thanks for your family, for the feast you share? Or maybe you'll give thanks for your hometown and the neighbors who always seem to be there when you need them most. A town like Wilmington, Ohio.
Wilmington is the type of town you wish you were from. You see those movies where they have this nostalgic little town. You think it's fake. It's not fake. It's Wilmington, Ohio.
Like so many American towns, Wilmington is down on its luck these days. Most families are struggling to get by.
Happy Thanksgiving, Wilmington!
They don't know they're about to meet a former waitress from upstate New York who plans to bring this community together for a Thanksgiving they'll never forget. But our story begins on Main Street.
Wilmington was like a Norman Rockwell painting. There was all this growth and excitement and big business, and there was no excuse not to have a job. If you wanted to work, there was a job to be had.
For 30 years, the air freight and shipping industries literally kept Wilmington alive, thriving, growing, really. 6 years ago, one of its largest employers, DHL, moved into the complex behind it. It seemed like everybody was working. The shops on Main Street were booming, and you could hear laughter coming from the restaurant at the General Denver Hotel.
It was exciting. You know, everything grew. There was industry.
You couldn't want for better people.
Going to town, everybody knows you. It's, you know, hey,
jobs was easy to find.
We were safe and secure. And
they even would have to go outside the town to get employees to fill jobs.
I don't think I'd live anyplace else.
It was a perfect little Midwest town.
And then, as our economy tumbled, everything changed.
9,500 people suddenly out of work at DHL.
It's shutting down a major portion of its U.S. operations.
Wilmington, Ohio will be hit hardest.
I had a meeting with the mayor of Wilmington about the DHL facility.
I'm deeply troubled by the specter of job loss confronting the town of Wilmington.
They're taking away everything from me, my family, my friends, this whole town.
So when the doors closed on this community's largest employer and 10,000 of the locals lost their jobs, to say that Wilmington was hit hard was an understatement.
It was devastating. We were all watching it on our computers because we knew they were having a press conference, and we all just looked at each other and we just knew it was the beginning of the end.
I don't want to be on unemployment. But that's all there is right now.
I don't want to ever have to drive by this house knowing somebody else owns it.
It's been almost a year and I've not been able to find a job.
I would get less than $300 a week on unemployment, and that'll be enough, you know, to just barely make the utilities.
So of course when people stop making money, they also stop spending money. It wasn't long before a bad situation became much worse, and much of the downtown area, well, it started closing up shop after shop.
My sleepless nights definitely have increased.
This place doesn't have any survival hope at all.
I have no insurance now at all. It was either eat and pay the bills or pay for insurance. Eating and paying the bills came first.
I didn't quit the job. The job quit me.
I'm 52 years old, and I've been here 52 years. I've seen a lot of changes. I've seen people come, I've seen people go.
You're starting to see these homes with grass growing high and no curtains in them, no cars in the driveway. So you know that their families are gone.
This is a very huge crisis. And not just here for Wilmington, but other towns across the United States.
Local farmer Randy McCamey always counted on his wife's salary to help keep their corn and soy farm a success. But it's been a solid year since she lost her job, and payments on the farm equipment are coming due.
My last day at work, I cried.
I spent probably 2 hours walking around telling everybody goodbye. I couldn't even drive. Because I just didn't know what was going to happen to me. And saying goodbye to all the people there that I'd come to love.
Bear in mind, just hang in there and help each other. We'll pull through. We'll pull through.